There is big news coming from Tesla Giga Berlin that may further delay the final approval. Brandenburg repeats online discussion of criticism of Tesla factory. Again, this is Armin Haryan from torchnews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news. The online discussions of more than 800 objections to the construction of the US electric car manufacturer Tesla's Giga factory in Grünheide on Oder-Spree is repeated again. The State Office for the Environment decided that for reasons of legal certainty. I reported last week that there may be new developments, and here we come, friends. Brandenburg repeats the questioning of critics of the Tesla Giga Berlin factory in Grünheide. The Ministry of the Environment said on Thursday that the State Office for the Environment decided this for reasons of legal certainty. The new procedure should therefore take place in the period from November 2 and November 22nd. Unless they approve in 8 days, forget about November approval of Tesla Giga Berlin. In doing so, the state is responding to criticism from the environmental associations Naturschutzbund, Nabu, Green League Brandenburg, Bund für Naturschutz, and Umwelt, Bund. Forgive my German, please. I don't speak German. As well as the Friends of Nature in Brandenburg. So these are the organizations. They accuse the environmental agency, the period between notice and the beginning of the online consultations, at least 1 week, to have failed to comply, that they didn't comply with the right deadline. They refer to a procedure for water rights for the Hambach opencast mine, for which a consultation was restarted because it had been announced 2 days in advance. Only after the end of the consultation on Tesla, can all objections be examined and answered, which is the prerequisite for a final building permit. The ministry announced that the example of the environmental associations is based on a large opinion that deviates from the previous interpretation. Because it is unclear how the administrative courts in Brandenburg will decide in the event of a lawsuit, the procedure will be repeated. The new discussions is to start on November 2nd. What is it? Today is October 22nd, in 10 days. So the announcement is scheduled for October 25th, said Potsdam. The comments from the latest discussion should therefore still be examined. If this goes on, friends, forget about November Giga Berlin approval, and we should wait maybe in December for the best scenario. Tesla expects approval for the end of 2021. Tesla wants to start production in its car factory this year, if possible. As the company said, the goal is to be able to build the first series cars Model Y before the end of the year. The construction of the Gigafactory is proceeding as planned. Batteries are also to be manufactured in Grünheide, as I've reported many times. However, there is no final approval for the state of Brandenburg for the Giga Berlin settlement. Tesla is currently building on the basis of early approval. We expect to receive the final approval before the end of this year, it said on Wednesday. The Ministry of the Environment, however, stated that a timetable for the decision on the Giga Berlin's permit could not be given. First of all, the new online discussion must also be evaluated. And here we go with this evaluation. Tesla's Giga Berlin factory building, friends, has attracted many critics and many supporters. Among other things, officials are fears scarce drinking water and negative consequences for the environment. Since Tesla had expanded the original plans to include the battery factory, the construction plans were redesigned for the public in the summer. According to the Brandenburg Ministry of the Environment, 395 objections were received by mid-October, so that a total of 809 people and organizations raised concerns in the approval process of Tesla Giga Berlin. So let me know what you think about Giga Berlin's final approval. When do you think the approval will come? I don't know, friends. We'll wait and see. Tesla just did something stunning. It offered a glimpse of a future without Elon Musk. A calm, coherent quarterly conference call previews what's to come. Again, this is Armin Haria from torquenews.com. Please subscribe to our channel and give us thumbs up if you like this report. Elon Musk may seem inseparable from Tesla, but on Wednesday night, the company offered the first real taste of what it might look like without its billionaire CEO. Tesla had held a regularly scheduled conference call to discuss its quarterly financial results, but as he had previously teased, Musk did not attend. His absence took what's normally a venue for his rants and rumblings, dismissals of Wall Street and attacks on the press, and turned into a coherent, if scripted, presentation of the company's recent progress, reports the media. There were fewer sideshows and more measured tone, though the executives who spoke in Elon Musk's place still made some contradictions. If Elon Musk were to leave his post atop the company, it's like that Tesla would look and sound a lot like how the company was presented on Wednesday night's call. Musk has talked about stepping down from Tesla for a few years, especially after the Model 3 and Model Y helped the company find some financial stability. Perhaps most notable, in July, Elon Musk testified in court that he had tried hard not to be the CEO at Tesla, but I had to or it would die, end of the quote. He wasn't kidding. He once said that the company was single-digit weeks away from collapse during the first big push to mass-produce the Model 3. It was around that time in 2018 that he got himself and Tesla sued by the Securities and Exchange Commission. The company also started facing some of the most intense waves of scrutiny about its autopilot software. Facing all that pressure, an admitted sleep-deprived Musk often used the quarterly earnings call to blow off steam. In late 2017, he yelled shame at journalists and their editors for writing about the company's layoffs. In early 2018, he cut off Wall Street analysts for asking boring, bonehead questions and started the practice of fielding inquiries from retail shareholders. 3 months after that, he apologized to those same analysts. In April 2020, he said that the shelter-in-place orders meant to stop the spread of COVID-19 were quote-unquote fascist. Friends, there was none of that Wednesday night. Taking Elon Musk's place was Tesla's chief financial officer, Zachary Kirkhorn, along with vice presidents Lars Morvay and Drew Baglino. The trio bounded through presentation pre-submitted questions from shareholders as well as live ones from the bankers. When asked about the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration's investigations into autopilot, they gave diplomatic answers about how they embrace the scrutiny of Tesla's products and preached cooperation. They still messaged some things though. Tesla is not just cooperating with NHTSA. It is partnering with the safety agency on the quote-unquote journey to the transition to a software-oriented vehicle, Kirkhorn said. By software-oriented vehicle, think of self-driving cars. Tesla is being extremely transparent, Kirkhorn said, about the ongoing test of the full self-driving beta software, they claimed, despite making owners signed non-disclosure agreements until very recently. The vibe certainly changed, but Kirkhorn and crew still obsessed over growth much like Musk. Kirkhorn recommitted to the company's goal of increasing the number of vehicles it builds each year by 50%. The Model Y is poised to be the best-selling vehicle in the world, Morvay said, Musk had imbued Tesla with a ton of momentum, and the executives who have remained with him clearly won't slow that down. If or when Musk steps down as Tesla CEO, the company will likely resemble the one on Wednesday's call. That's how it will look like. But do you think Elon Musk is planning or will step down? I don't know. If you know, let me know, when do you think this will happen? So what's unknowable is how Tesla would respond to Elon Musk's use of Twitter if he occupies a different perch. Right now, when he tweets about making changes to Tesla products, the people who work at the company have a pretty explicit obligation to make those changes happen. If he is in a reduced role or removed from the company entirely, perhaps to focus more on SpaceX, growing operations in Texas, will Tesla's executives give those tweets the same kind of weight? I don't know. If you guys know, let me know, please, in the comment section below. Perhaps when Elon Musk isn't CEO of Tesla, his public proclamations will have less of an effect on the company's sky-high stock price. Elon Musk even said at one point that he believed the share price was too high, though that was billions of dollars worth of valuation and the stock split ago. So the market has proven its willingness to ignore him before. For what it's worth, Tesla's stock price closed higher than ever on Thursday. Friends, Tesla has now turned a profit in 9 straight quarters and 11 of the last 13 quarters, pure profit. It still got its fair share of challenges though ahead as it continues to build up factories in new places around the globe, but the company appeared to be in the kind of shape Musk has said is required before he'd consider leaving. So it's a safe place. Maybe this is why Tesla is giving us a hint. A company without Elon Musk maybe will get a chance to evaluate his influence on Tesla from something other than the CEO role sooner than later. If you guys have any idea on that, let me know. We'll discuss in the comment section below.